Ah, lights. Shift my light back a bit. Not in my frame. I'm a professional. I did videography for a living. Here I am. Oh, man. Whew. Yeah. Exciting first moments of the stream. You get to listen to the rumple of a paper bag and watch me take a pill. So I have to get a root canal on Friday. Super exciting. I'm thrilled. I actually really like the dentist. I find it very relaxing. But nobody came here to watch me talk about the dentist. So let's take a look at this here. This is my new Skyrim spreadsheet. So it's going to expand sort of as we go. But ideally today, what I want to do is sort of establish like a character archetype for every quest. And then also sort of figure out what their fighting style is. We'll figure out where they, like, the things that matter for characters for me is sort of their archetype, which is manifest in their fighting style. What kinds of quests they're interested in, where they live, sort of how they fight with spells, melee, ranged, and what kind of armor they wear, who they hang out with. And then the other thing is the unlock. So the first time I did a multiplicity, this will be about my eighth one. And maybe I should back this up a bit and talk about what a multiplicity is. So a multiplicity is where I'm going to make like 13 Skyrim characters, 12 Skyrim characters. And they're all going to be in the same game, and we're going to use the presets that we used last week and some sort of creative character editing to tell all of their stories sort of intermingled. It's a multiplicity. Instead of having one character in a game, you have 11 characters in a game, or 12 characters, or 50 characters, or whatever. I think the biggest one I've done is like 13. And it lets me tell a whole lot of different stories, and that's what I want to do here. So these are all the major quest lines. There are a couple that are from mods. So Helgen Reborn is shockingly from the mod Helgen Reborn. Wormstooth is from Wormstooth. It's a Dragon Slayer mod. It's super fun. And there's a couple other mods that I haven't included, like Falskar and Elsewhere, mostly because I don't know very much about them. The only thing I did in Falskar when I got there, I went there accidentally and then I left because I wanted to leave it untouched. And Dragonborn isn't on here because I dumped that in the main quest because my Dragonborn character does the main quest and then you go on to do Dragonborn, which I have never done. So I'm excited to do this sometime in the next, like, I don't know, billion months when we're doing this stream. If there are any issues with the audio, please let me know and I'll sort of tweak some settings. I just got the lights figured out and I remembered to take my meds, so I'm kind of a half-assembled human today. Dentistry. Yay. So, the unlock is what gives me the ability to use that character. And it matters to me because, this is going to sound really weird, but if you have like 13 characters to play and you don't sort of know which one you really feel like, and we're going to switch it up a whole bunch, and what you wind up having is this sort of indecision, and it gets boring, and I'm not into that. So what I decided to do was sort of what unlocks a character, and that'll be based on their archetype. We're going to pick their archetypes, we're going to pick their names, we make some notes about the kinds of people they are, like whether they like the Stormcloaks or the Thalmor or whatever. Spoilers, nobody likes the Thalmor. I'm glad that we got that figured out right now. So let's start with some archetypes here. And I'll sort of go down by quest type because it's easier. I have a long list of them that I unpack into other things. So fortresses are people who wear heavy armor and fight with two-handed weapons, and usually some sort of like shout at range or something that keeps their hands free. Knights fight with sort of a one-hand shield, and they, and it's all sort of, I made it up off the cuff. Like, this is just, this sort of describes lists of characters that I have played in the past, and the kinds of characters they have been. So who do we want to do a big brutish quest where we are gonna become a werewolf? I don't know if we're gonna get cured yet. I very much prefer werewolf to vampirism, just because you don't get a lot of penalties with it. And I've got some really fun werewolf mods. We might even just make a werewolf character, or like a pugilist character. Somebody who fights unarmed. That'd be super tough. I like it. Werewolf character would be tricky, but here we are. But maybe let's pick a, rather than somebody who fights in melee and that kind of thing, maybe let's pick a warlock. And they're gonna fight with warlock spells, which are part of, so they're gonna have spells as a ranged attack. They're gonna wear no armor. And do they have a melee attack? So I've got a bunch of options here. One of the options for melee attacks is bodyguards. With the follower mods, you can assemble like two or three bodyguards. It's super fun. Trust me. There's something fun about, for a little while, like casting support spells and just sort of standing back and watching your bodyguards beat people up. It turns Skyrim into a little bit more of a strategic game, because obviously the best person you know at murdering people is you. But I think we'll actually go with, she has no melee attacks. Now we're obviously going to need a melee attack to, I'm just going to add that to the list because I forgot to. We're going to need a melee attack to pass one of the first companion's quests, but other than that, we can probably get through it without having to melee fight anybody, and we'll just burn people down with warlock spells. So the obvious unlock for that is quest, the companion's quest, and warlock spells. What should we name them? Throw a name in chat. If you got ideas. Or if you have like a fighting style you'd like to see go with a quest. Dawnguard. We'll go in order. We'll do Thieves Guild next. I've never finished all the Thieves Guild stuff either. It never really appealed to me. And I'm not really good at the whole stealth minigame. So I never really got into it. But I do like picking archetypes that are sort of, I mean, obviously we've got a thief archetype, which is like light armor and daggers and stuff like that. And then the ninja one, which is like light armor and various bits of ninja gear that I have for mods. I've never actually run a ninja because it seems super boring. Who should we make our Thieves Guild person? Leader is probably an awful idea on account of the whole, like, they travel with a bunch of people. Bravo. So Bravos, in my head at least, fight with rapiers, and they shoot people with crossbows. So Yeah, thanks. Thanks. I'm still working on the spreadsheet, unfortunately. I figure it will evolve as we do it. Crossbow, well, light armor, because all of Thieves Guild armor is light, and we'll specifically wear Thieves Guild armor. So we're obviously going to go Thieves Guild. Rapier. Crossbow. Hey, John, how's it going? I'm working on spreadsheets. I'm going to define sort of who all of these people are and who they hang out with. I don't want to worry about where they live yet. Do they use spells? Or do they use stealth spells? That'll probably make my life a bit easier. Dawnguard. Somebody who fights vampires. I kind of want to do like a two-weapon fighter. Like somebody who's like a super just weeaboo fighter. Seriously, spreadsheets? John's like, yay, spreadsheets. I'm like, yeah. Spreadsheets are how I keep my fucking Skyrim game straight. Otherwise, I wouldn't know how to do anything. I wouldn't know where I was. I understand how dorky that is. I don't care. I care a lot. Alright, so I kind of want to do a dervish for Dawnguard, partly because you can get a bunch of weapons that drastically affect undead and vampires, and having a dervish will like double that effect, so we can get that sword that like makes undead explode and stuff like that, and enchant up some undead gear, and having two weapons will make that pretty spectacular. So let's be a dervish. We're doing Dawnguard. I thought about having the like, oh, you unlock the Dawnguard quest, but actually I think we want to go with Morthal Vampires. The Dawnguard quest doesn't unlock until like level 10, and with the slower leveling from the mods, it's going to take a while to get there. But maybe Morthal Vampires, maybe... the Gem of Meridia. Meridia is the Daedra who gives you that quest to go and retake her shrine from the Necromancer, and you get that cool ass undead sling sword. But I don't remember when that unlocks, and I don't want it to be too late, or we're never gonna see this person before Dawnguard. So they're gonna fight with dual wield, ranged attacks. It probably needs some kind of ranged attack, especially against vampires. Let's try thrown weapons, which I picked up from a mod. And they're super fun. Light, heavy, or no armor? What do you think? We'll leave it up for open question to the floor. We'll throw in chat. Spells. We'll maybe get some armor spells. Got a bunch of Forgotten Magic introduces a bunch of like long-term buff spells, which are super fun. College Winterhold. Yeah, we're definitely gonna kill the Whiterun Dragon pretty early on, just because there's a whole ton of stuff that unlocks as soon as you do that. Also, once we kill the first dragon in Whiterun, whose name I cannot remember, Mirmalnir or something like that, it's going to start our assault timer. Which means once every 3 to 5 days, a dragon will show up to fight us wherever we are, unless we're like in a city. So as soon as we kill that guy, we need to be like prepped for dragon slaying, because otherwise life gets real unfortunate. The worst is when you're like in a spot where a dragon already spawns, because dragons don't spawn until you finish that quest. And then you're in a spot where a dragon spawns, and then your assault pops, and you're like, oh, now I have to fight two dragons. I'm level 3. Deadlier Dragons is super fun. I love that mod. but it, early game, it can be just terrifyingly bad. So Winterhold, I mean, there's some cool options here. I mean, these are just things I made up to pick from, but there's obviously any kind of options. I really want to try a sword and ward. The game is set to normal. I usually bump games down to easy for streaming, but Skyrim, I am good enough at Skyrim that I'll just play it on normal. I used to only ever play games on Nightmare, and then I sort of got past that. I was like, no, I want to finish games and enjoy them. I learned sort of what I needed to do there. Why don't we make the... Rather than like a wizardy type, why don't we make them like a paladin or a thunder god? Or a death knight. We've already got warlocks, so I don't necessarily want to overlap. Because death knights also use warlock spells, typically. Like draining stuff and damage over time and things like that. Thunder god would be pretty fun, though. So thunder god is a build I put together that obviously uses lightning spells. And there's a bunch of sick lightning spells in some of these mods. They fight with sword and board. And I use like a hammer and a shield, like Thor. Ranged is obviously spells. And their armor is heavy. So they wear like just heavy like barbarian style armor. We'll see what we can get them. What unlocks the Thunder God? Let's see if we can unlock the Thunder God through a Meteor Shower. No. Because I have a Meteor Shower mod, but I don't know. What unlocks the Thunder God? Rain. First time it rains. So we have to have some lightning spells, and it has to rain. Say the first time it rains. First time it rains after we have lightning spells. So right now we don't have any. So if we want to unlock him, then... Or her. We don't actually know the gender of any of these characters yet. Or them. We're definitely going to make some non-gendered characters, I think. And then we'll be able to sort of gear that up. Civil War, Imperial... We're obviously fighting on the side of the Imperials. And let's go with a War Archer. Archers get really fun in Civil War because you can sort of sit back. You don't have to clutter your vision with all the soldiers that are there. We'll unlock, obviously, join the Legion. And also, we'll need to kill a Stormcloak. So we haven't done that yet. We haven't found any Stormcloaks. We haven't seen any. So we'll also, we have to kill a Stormcloak before we can have our War Archer go and sign up for the Legion. And she might use some nature spells, maybe? Some archery spells. Melee will give her... or them, I guess. My last War Archer was a lady. Like an axe. Ranged is a longbow. And armor... Let's go with light. Sort of fits the motif. Dark Brotherhood. I have never done the Dark Brotherhood quests. I passed the very, very first one. I have never done the Dark Brotherhood quests. I killed the Lady of the Orphanage, and then I slept and got a talking to, but that was as far as I got. and then I wandered off to do something else. I feel like we want somebody unassuming to do the Dark Brotherhood quests. Either somebody who is a wizard, or like rather than the usual like stealth assassin, maybe like a magus or a mystic. I feel like mystic would be a little more fun. Mystics, in my head, mystics are conjurers. It's sort of illusion, restoration, conjuration. You summon creatures and then make them fight people, and then buff them until they can kill anyone. I feel like we want to get a little more personal than that. Mm-hmm. Because we can go Magus and get some, like, Fire Mage or Ice Mage or something like that. Let's go with Thief, though. I think so. Somebody who's, like, they've joined the Thieves Guild and they, you know, because so they're already in Riften. They get this quest and they know about the orphanage and they do it, and then they wind up mixed up in this thing that they don't really know about or want to be a part of. So we'll go with Thieves Guild. So they're not gonna do any Thieves Guild quests, but we're still gonna need to have that unlocked. And let's go with. So they fight with a conjured blade. In melee and some kind of spell at range. Where. Light armor, I guess? We got a lot of light armor people. So let's make them no armor. Let's make our dervish light, though. Because we want to wear that sweet-looking Dawnguard armor. And the kinds of spells we're going to get in terms of like range spells and whatnot, I'm not sure. Let's keep our options open. Because there's some non-elemental type spells that might be pretty fun. But if not, we'll default to, like, fire or ice or something. This is the Bard College. I've only ever done one or two of the Bard quests, too. I will point out that I have, like... where is Skyrim? I have 934 hours in Skyrim. So, I have played this game a ton, and there's still a huge amount that I've never done. All right. Bard College. The Bard College, if I recall, it's not a long quest chain. And it's the kind of thing that, you know, you maybe want to have somebody. Do you wind up doing a lot of dungeon crawling and stuff like that? Given that it's not a long quest chain, I kind of want to have our like a Death Knight do it, but I think we'll stay on theme. We'll have a Death Knight do the Daedra quest. Just because, you know, it'll be more fun. Okay. And then for the Bard College, we get a Spellblade. I really want to do a Spellblade, but I don't think I want to do them for that. We'll get a Spellblade to do either Worm's Teeth or Helgen Reborn. Let's go with Helgen Reborn. Because it's a longer quest chain. And you fight less dragons. The Bard College. Or a leader, actually, yeah. Let's get a leader. So leaders, in my head, are people who fight typically with bodyguards. And their spells are support spells, so they use things like courage to buff their bodyguards to give them more health. They heal their bodyguards and find other ways to buff them. And they also use conjured creatures. So we'll make them have summon spell. Courage. Three command words. And their ranged attacks are none, because they're not going to be attacking anybody directly. And armor. Make them heavy armor. So they're super tough, but they don't actually physically fight. Thane. So we're going to do all the Thane quests. Obviously, we're going to become Thane of everywhere. Who does the Thane quests? And sort of secure those holds. What have we got left that we don't have a spot in? We get a Mystic, we get a Magus, we get a Ninja, Paladin, Fortress. We'll go with Fortress. So somebody with just a giant two-hander, heavy armor, and let's say we need to be the Thane of Whiterun to start that off. So Thane of Whiterun, obviously you're going to get like right in the beginning of the game, as soon as you kill the dragon there. It's the easiest one to get. The hardest one I think is Solitude, because you have to do a bunch of quests and buy the house there, and the house is really expensive. Or Dawnstar. Oh, no. Duh. The hardest one is Windhelm, because we're on the Imperial side, which means we need to win the Civil War before we can become Thane of Windhelm. So they fight with a two-hander. We'll give them some spells, though. Maybe they fight with fire spells as our ranged attack. And we'll give them heavy armor. So we're going to kit them out, basically, with some super sweet fire spells. So Death Knight. Death Knight's obviously going to do our Daedra quests. They're going to make deals with Daedra. And that's going to include Mean Daedra as well. Or Nice Daedra, rather. So not just Molech Bal, which is the go-to Daedra thing, because you get the Mace of Molech Bal, which is super, super cool and super useful. Which, by the way, this quest is a lot harder in my game because there's a mod, I think it's Blood Witch Armor? It puts a chest in that house that's full of the armor from the mod, but it's guarded by two master vampires. So I walked in there by mistake one time, being like, oh, I'll do this quest and get this cool item and then we'll do some stuff with it, and I just got hammered by two master vampires. They just annihilated me. We're not going in there until at least like level 8. So this guy unlocks when we have two or more Daedra quests. So that'll include what are the obvious ones to get? The one with the talking dog for Clavicus Vile, the Mace of Molech Bal one, the Shrine of Azura one, and the one from Meridia that you sort of find. Oh, and the one for, I think it's Sheogorath in the Imperial Palace, or in the palace in Solitude. Suppose I have not done all of the Daedra quests yet. So that's going to be super fun. Death Knights obviously fight with Warlock spells, so they're going to have the advantage because our Warlock's going to level up a bunch of those spells for us. Warlocks, by the way, are super useless against Undead. Or Vampires, specifically. So this might actually bonus a bit in the companion quest when we have to fight all this Draugr. I don't remember. We're going to find out. But I don't think so. No. Warlocks are supposed to be good. Draugr are sort of weirdly technically people. Melee, Death Knight's going to fight. They're going to fight with a sword. So let's go sword and shield for now. And they're going to wear heavy armor as well. They're looking a lot like our fortress. The only real difference is maybe this, because they might wind up fighting two-handed anyway. I have something very special planned for this Death Knight. And you'll see. They're looking a lot like our fortress, though. They're basically a fortress that, like, wears different armor and uses different spells. And that's okay, because we're going to differentiate them by the armor that they wear. We're going to differentiate them by, sort of the way that they look. And that's going to be when we get to the character creation step, which is going to be the next one. All right, our Spellblade. So Helgen Reborn, what it is you essentially, it's a huge mod. It's got voice acting, it's the whole nine, and it is wonderful. You rebuild Helgen and do a bunch of quests for this, like, sort of lone, exiled Imperial Legion that's living there under the radar. Until finally Helgen is like a big thriving, it's a real town again. And you've resolved a bunch of character arcs and things like that. So, Helgen Reborn, which is the quest, we can activate that as soon as we beat the dragon. So let's put in the restriction on this. College of Winterhold. So, our Spellblade, because they fight with sword and ward. So they're going to have, rather than the thief here, who's got a conjured blade, who fights specifically with a conjured blade, they might fight with a conjured blade. But they don't have to. They can fight with a physical sword, but their offhand is going to be ward shield spells. Which are super weird and super fun to use. Ranged, they're also going to use spells. And we'll figure out what kind we want them to use later, and we'll give them heavy armor too, because we're gonna get a unique, cool set of heavy armor out of Helgen Reborn, and it'll be really fun to wear that as part of the character. Maybe we'll see. I might have some other ideas there. But this is somebody who, you know, they tried out at the college. And they got as far as, teaching them their first ward spell. So, they learned their first ward spell in that little bit. And then they head to a bar they get an invitation to a bar. To head to a bar in Whiterun, and they wind up mixed up in this whole Helgen thing and fighting Thalmor, and they never wind up going back to the college. So that'll be a fun story to tell. So we're going to expand this outward too. Like, eventually we're going to have, you know, things like spouses and maybe proxies. I'm not sure that we want to get that dorky, but we'll see. The last one is Wormstooth. We're going to kill a ton of dragons in Worm's Tooth. I mean, a ton. We're gonna kill like 8. So we need a Dragon Slayer. And nobody kills dragons better than knights. We're gonna unlock our knight though, maybe with the first bounty. So like they're like an exile knight, you know, like an old blade maybe. and something else. Tier 2 sword or shield, so that'll be Dwemer or Elven. You know, they're teched up a little bit. You know, they've got this sword that they found, because knights are gonna of course fight sword and board. Ranged attack. We got a lot of people using spells as ranged attacks. I think that this person is also the Dragonborn. They will use shouts, and they will of course wear heavy armor. Spells, they might use armor spells, but they're not going to use much else. So here we have the basics. Yes, we've just spent half an hour looking at a spreadsheet about Skyrim, and I have established, quote, the basics. But this is the start of real stories. I mean, this is... Our warlock is somebody who's drawn to darkness, but not to sort of darkness and honor. And they're drawn to the companions. And the companions is full of fighters, but they're also a fighter, just in a different way. And they're going to grapple with sort of being a werewolf and things like that. Our Bravo, you know, joins the Thieves Guild for a good time and gets wrapped up in those Thieves Guild quests. Our Dervish joins the Dawn Guard after killing a bunch of vampires in Morthal, and maybe possibly being chosen by a Daedra to, again, fight evil spirits and inherit a blade that kills vampires. So when they hear about the Dawn Guard, they're going to be like 100% on board. I'm really intrigued to use throwing weapons with them. I forget, I think there might be some hotkeying issues with throwing weapons. I'm going to have to screw around with it. But if not, we'll figure it out. So we've got a bunch. We've got 4 people in light armor. We've got 6 people in heavy armor. We've got 2 people with no armor. So we might want to lighten up that bodyguard a bit, or that body armor a bit, just to get some diversity in our armor selection. Skyrim dress up is very important. We've got our Thunder God, who awakens sort of at that intersection between weather and magic. And they're going to go on to become an ascendant wizard, essentially. Our war archer, who hates the Stormcloaks and, you know, sort of kills them at every opportunity they get. Our thief, who, as we said, gets mixed up in the Dark Brotherhood problems. And they're also an untraceable killer because they keep their own weapons within them. Our leader, who goes to the Bard College and sort of recruits some friends to go on adventures. Our fortress, who becomes Thane in the sort of traditional Nord fashion by just gutting it out and bashing their way to the top in every town. Our Death Knight, who is perhaps revived or chosen by the Daedra to carry out their will. So it's interesting that the Dervish is going to get this quest. The Death Knight is going to do it. So that's going to be... That implies to me that they have some kind of relationship. And this is where we get into, like, the super nerdy bits, right? Where you're like, okay, well, if the Death Knight does that quest and gets that sword, how does the Dervish wind up with it? Well, they obviously know each other. Why do they know each other? The Spellblade, yeah, we mentioned, you know, fails out of the college or leaves the college, goes drinking one night and winds up, you know, pulling jobs for the Keepers of Hatu, which is the faction that will control Helgen eventually. And they're not, our knight, who I think is like an old blade who lives to just kill dragons. So here's what we're going to do, at least for now. Because this is the preliminary stuff. Now we get into the harder bits. So what we're going to do is I'm going to sort of move the spreadsheet around a little bit. Negotiate some things. And I'm going to actually start up my Skyrim game. Which means I need to turn off that music and launch my Skyrim script extender. I'm still attempting to find a way to export and post my mod list. Nexus doesn't really have a good way of doing that. And currently all of my deactivated mods are mixed in, and I haven't cleaned those up because I'm an awful garbage human being, basically. All right. So here we are. Legit Skyrim. Let's do this thing. Kind of. So, when last we left off, we were in the house that I was completely and utterly gushing over. Because I fucking love this house. Our Dragonborn is definitely going to live there. And that's going to be like the central area. By the way, our multiplicity is going to accrue more people. It is. There are a few like support classes and things like that that are super fun to have. Like a merchant or a smith. I'm going to do a lot of smithing off camera. Just because it can get really boring and tedious. And partly because I want to save some of my like cooler smithing mods as a surprise. But for now, we need to make these characters and turn them into people. So, choice menu. So here is Janet. Janet is the Dragonborn. Look at her. She's super sane as shit. Oh, I love Janet. Now, you need to help me out by helping me name characters. It's important. We're going to name like 10 people, and they're going to be with us for the next, I don't even know how long. Months. Months of streaming. So, I need help naming them. Otherwise, they're all going to be named Steve's 1 through 10. I'm kidding, but only a little. So, the first one up is our Warlock. And we can determine gender through the obvious way, which is Rockin' Queen Lady. Or concentric circles in my 2-pound piece. So heads is, because it has a rock and queen lady, is always going to be ladies. Tails is dudes. Our warlock is a lady. Okay. She's going to be a lady. Drawn to honor and darkness, as we mentioned. She's going to do the companions quest. If you were just joining us, I'm really kind of sorry. This is just gonna get super nerdy. Okay, so let's make her a little sort of thinner and smaller than Janet. Because Janet is a giant. Let's make her super pale. Oh right, because if we change the presets then. So let's pick a preset first. I like the presets because, the reason why we can't change race is because if you change race using show race menu, it will super screw up your skill points. And I haven't figured out a way around that yet. So we're all going to be Imperials. That person looks warlockish. Because I don't like screwing with the features, just because 90% of the time you wind up with a human being who looks like a monster. So let's make them a little paler. So maybe weather their... we won't weather their complexion yet. They're unstained by darkness. Let's set their eye color, though. Let's move the camera up a bit. There we go. So. Yes, come to the Skyrim stream. Watch us play with... Sliders. Playing with Sliders is my probably third favorite game in the universe. I'm kidding, I fucking hate it, but that's why I do it all at the beginning. Do we just want to go with like the creepy black eyes for Warlock? If you have literally any ideas, put them in the chat, because I will probably do them. But in the meantime, we're going to play with Sliders. Maybe not black eyes yet. Maybe... ooh, damn, that looks creepy as shit. I like that they, like, label these things, like, human eyes, earth. What does that mean? Yeah, maybe emerald green. Like, something like that's just super, super green. That's ridiculous. All right. Skip all that stuff because I'm just going to make a person who looks awful. Let's pick a hair color. I don't do custom hair colors on account of I'm super, super colorblind. And unless you want a person with neon blue hair running around, like, I couldn't even pick out neon blue, actually. I am awful at that. Let's do somebody who's like, oh, these colors are all boring. My world for like 19 more hair colors. Alright, fine. You get to be whatever hair color this is. But we are going to give you some cool ass hair. Let's zoom out a bit. So you're going to be a warlock. You're going to wear no armor. For women, I have a preference. I know there's a lot of cool, like, long hairstyles, and there is, but I have a preference for hairstyles that are worn up, just because they interfere with armor meshes less. So you can see here that, like, the hair is through the, it's clipping through the armor. So it looks like a Helen. Yeah, that seems legit. Helen it is. I work with a Helen. She's basically a warlock. That joke was entirely for one person in our audience. Well, I'm not going to say who it is. Bows? No, let's not go with bows. That looks pretty sweet. What does it look like from the back? It's pretty close to the back. We might need to... Helen. Focus. We might need to mess around with it a bit. That looks pretty good. Oh, there we go. I'm digging that. Let's make her hair a little darker, though. Okay. Now we're going to do something that I forgot to do, so we're going to name her real quick, and I like Helen, so Helen it is. Everybody remember Helen the Warlock? I forgot to take off my armor. This isn't just for showing off, it's because it's going to be a lot easier to customize our tattoos when we can actually see a person's entire body. So, expressions. He's not powering up or anything. So we're going to close that off. Give her... it's puzzled. Ooh. Sad? No. Okay, I see what this is doing. Let's crank up the combat anger a bit. Oh, look at Helen. She looks mad. Let's maybe dial down the mood anger a touch. No, actually. I like the mood anger. But let's give her a smile. No. Do we just have a smile? Mood happy affects their, like, eyebrows and stuff. Dialogue happy. Oh god, that's awful. Man. I don't know what has to make you so happy. I just want you to smile. Come for the stream where I create women in their underwear and then tell them to smile like a fucking monster. Alright, here we are. So yeah, like, sort of narrow eyes, but just a little amused. Like someone who's about to kill you and doesn't feel too bad about it. Alright, so we're naturally going to give her some face paint. So let's see what we got here. Something sort of mystical but understated. That's not exactly what I'm looking for. The runes are pretty good. Like something sort of warlocky. It's a little much, maybe. Oh, what was that? That looks pretty. Nordic runes around the. Ooh, there we are. Hi, Henry. How's it going? I am making characters for a complex and nerdy game of Skyrim that we're just getting started. I like that. That's understated. We might add more to it later, too. And then let's pick some tattoos. What's up, humans? We're making Skyrim characters. Like dorks. So we're not going to give her a giant back tattoo, probably. You know, I might get rid of my freckle mod, not because I don't like the idea of freckles, but because I can't color them properly. Again, super colorblind. So, and nobody wants, like, just black freckles. That looks weird. Let's try and filter. There's a bunch of vampire tattoos. Let's see what we can get out of there. That looks sweet as shit, and we're totally gonna use it. Alright, so she has a sick vampire tattoo. Are there any other cool-ass vampire tattoos that we can get on, like, an arm? These tattoos are from, I completely forget what, tattoo mod. And is there... What is that? What is that? I bet it's awful. The vampire leg tattoos, if I recall, are complete garbage. It's a big circle with a star in the middle. That's brilliant. Yes, let's not do that. Let's forget we ever saw that. Game, I need you to cooperate. Oh yeah, no, Faendal is... I'm not sure that that's romantic, though. I think Faendal and I are just friends. I think that... Like, he looks disapproving. He's like, why are you in your underwear? What are you were we not doing literally anything? We can give her a wolf, tattoo. You have like a set of wolf prints like on the running up the back of her leg. That's subtle as shit. I dig it. Okay. Oh, let's adjust the camera. Let's pull her face back into view like civilized human beings. Body scales. We're going to scale down her height a bunch. Maybe she's a little shorter than average. So she's no Janet, that's for sure. Janet is our dragonborn, and Janet is a giant. And there we go. Welcome to Helen. Helen, everybody. Helen the Warlock, who is going to do the Companions quest and kick ass at it. So, let's save this preset. Helen. Helen the Warlock. Saved. And now we have Helen. So we know what she looks like, we know what her story is going to be, at least a little bit, until we figure out the rest. I'm just entering some stuff in the spreadsheet. Like her name. And now Skyrim is giving me a bunch of crap. There we go. There we are. Okay. Yeah, Fandol's just got his arms crossed. He's like, seriously, you're just... You move into a house and you just take off all your pants. Awesome. Alright, so show race menu. Our next character is a Bravo. This is our thief. Our Bravo who is going to join the Thieves Guild and sort of on sort of a lark, and then wind up becoming presumably the greatest thief in Skyrim, perhaps the entire multiverse. Shut up, Dak Faden, move over. So again, gender determined randomly. Queen face. Heads as always, ladies. Tails. Our thief is a dude. Our first dudesman. Alright. Welcome, dudesman. You look concerned. You're making a face. That's good. Let's change your preset. God, you're all making that face. Please stop it. Just stop. You look awful. So much better. Look fine on Helen. You're not Helen. Let's just go with that. You're not Helen. So who we got here? We've got handsome sort of Roman dude. Somebody's uncle. Somebody's super buff construction worker uncle. I got plans for you later, maybe, dude. Somebody's sad little brother. Game, could you please cooperate? Thank you. No. Your manager at work. Your manager's manager. Jason Momoa. Jason Momoa's manager. Alright, so he's a Bravo, so he's gonna be like sort of handsome-y, but not like, you know, like in a rugged way. Maybe not so mousy-faced. Do we want him to be like super huge Roman guy? I don't think so. I think that we want somebody, maybe this guy. We can. Son, you're getting a haircut. That's your problem. You just need a haircut, and then you'll be all better. Let's give you maybe a little bit more weight. Let's darken your skin a bit. You know, you've been out in the sun a little more. Complexion. We were going to make you very youthful. You are kind of an urchin, so we're going to give you some dirt. You've got a scar. Looks very good. I'm a fan. Oh, that's eye shape. We want eye color. Blue smoke. That looks pretty cool. You sort of look like Johnny Depp's shitty cousin. Well, to be fair, Johnny Depp is probably your shitty cousin. All right, son, let's do something about this hair. We gotta do something here. You're a Bravo, you need good hair. It's like a rule. If you're gonna fight with a rapier, you gotta have great hair. That's why I never learned defense. Oh, here we go. Now we're getting... Fauxhawk? Fauxhawk? Fauxhawk's a strong maybe. We're not gonna go with the Super Saiyan hair because that's Janet's haircut. And if Janet catches you, like, aping her haircut, she's gonna kill you. Make no mistake, she will kill you. You could have white guy dreads. That's probably an idea that we're never, ever going to pursue. Ooh, the, like, straight-up leading man Errol Flynn hair. I'm digging that. Let's keep going and see what we got. Look at that. Look at this man. Look at his handsome hair. Can we give you a pompadour? That'd be amazing. You can have some kind of... We're totally gonna have somebody who's blind. Oh, yeah. I don't know who yet, but we're gonna have somebody who's blind. Maybe you're a dervish, like a blind two-weapon fighter. That seems pretty fun. Oh, man. That's number 44. Let's remember that one. Ooh, wait. I worked with this guy. Yeah, no, every startup has this guy. Also this guy. Actually, this guy is me. This is what my hair does. It's what my hair is literally doing right now. Is this my self-insert character? He's a Bravo who joins the Thieves Guild. Maybe he is my self-insert character. That's a sweet haircut. Are you? You're just sort of like, you woke up, you ran a comb through your hair. I appreciate the effort. Thanks for showing up. All the, like, strategically messy look. I think we're going to start with strategically messy. Because he's going to be shitty to start. And then we're going to maybe tweak it later. Facial hair. Let's give you a jerk haircut. Or, like, facial hair thing. Because, again, we're going to come in and edit these characters and sort of change them as they grow as people. Yeah. You look like the dude who played the Scarecrow in Batman Begins. Yeah. Let's check your hair color. Oh, we could make you blonde. You look adorable. You look like Paul Bettany. You look like Paul Bettany after he got in a fight. God, guys, why are your hair colors so much more diverse? I actually know the answer to that, and it's not a good one. Yeah, we're gonna make you blonde. Look at you. Aren't you cute? You're so cute. You're like, I've got a 5 o'clock shadow and a scar, and I'm a cool guy. I'm a cool guy who could join a cool club. I'm a cool guy who could maybe steal one thing in my whole life. We're gonna mess you up something bad, son. All right, let's give you an expression. Let's make you happy. Yeah, look at that. Look at that. Look at your boyish charm. You're just like, you have a British accent, sir. I don't care that this is Skyrim. Cillian Murphy, thank you. I could not remember that guy's name. He was also in that really cool movie about flying a thing into the sun, which I cannot remember the name of. Yeah, man, look at you have a British accent. There's no fucking way you don't. I mean, yeah, no, 100%. You're just like, you show up in Skyrim and you're like, hey guys, how's it going? I'm here to sort of hang out. And I was hoping that maybe you'd want to hang out with me. Dex, I am a pretty new streamer, off and on. This is a new channel for me. We streamed D&D for a couple of years over on YouTube. And I was like, man, I'm not doing enough with Twitch. We used to do a charity stream once a year, playing Borderlands for children's hospitals over at Headshot's Heart. But this is my personal channel, and I am sort of mucking about with streaming. So yeah, I'm pretty new. I mostly spend a lot of time on YouTube. I make Minecraft videos and podcasts and things like that. So you can find that over on youtube.com/wootsuitriot or youtube.com/jtigwell. Shameless self-promotion. Thank you, person in the chat, for asking about my stream so I can plug my shit. Anyway, we're talking about fucking Paul Bettany here. Man, yeah, this guy... This is the guy that every other guy in Skyrim wants to beat up. Yeah, I want to do another charity stream. We did it for about 3 years. We raised about $11,000 for Child's Play, and it was a lot of fun. It was a hell of a lot of work, and then we sort of real life intervened, jobs, health stuff. The problem with being in your 30s is that staying up for 24 hours makes you want to die, and we're only getting older. But there might be some more stuff coming down the pike in, I want to say, a year. It depends on how some stuff goes. 24-hour podcast is probably not going to be a thing, but that'd be it'd be a lot of fun for some people, mostly me. So let's give this guy a war paint color. Did our Skyrim just crash? No, we are good. Okay. Yeah, this guy's smug as shit. I love this guy. Okay. So, let's... Do we want to give this guy... I think we want to give this guy some kind of war paint. Like, we want him to have something like... Like, he needs a sick neck tattoo, is what I'm saying. Like, not something that's on his face. He'd never mess up his beautiful face. That's not... But he's like, you know, one night I got super drunk and I got a tattoo and it was a great idea at the time. Yeah, it was just a big spiral on my head. And I thought, man, this is going to help me pick up dudes. But yeah, I'm thinking like a little hieroglyph on his neck. Something that makes him look deep. He's just like, oh, you know, got it when I was in my Egyptian phase. You know, it's sort of nice. You went Australian there for a second. That's probably fine. I'm just gonna save that color so that I can reuse it. So we can get into body paint. He looks like the kind of guy who couldn't leave a black eye from hitting on your girlfriend. Is what he looks like. He's like, oh, there, I'm British. I'm from around. You might have heard of it. You might not. Probably not. We're totally giving him a sick wolf tattoo on his arm. That looks cool. I'm digging it. I'm gonna go with. Nope. I know how to organize key presses and operate a keyboard. Hope so. Do it for a living. We're definitely gonna give him a thief marker. Because all of my, as I mentioned, all of my thief characters have thief markers. Because the thief tattoos in this set. And in this mod are so cool, but let's give him one that's like somewhere a little more subtle. Wolf tattoos on the front of his left arm, so let's sort of balance that out. Oh, all right, sliders. It's like 8 o'clock. We've spent an hour just making Skyrim characters. So there's one on the back there. Get one on the back of his leg. On a opposite shoulder. I'm digging that. And ideally, I mean, you know, sort of in my imagination, he doesn't have these tattoos yet, but I don't want to have to go in and screw around with it. I want to get it all done right now, because setting tattoos is a pain in the butt. And we're going to give him a third one, because everybody gets 3 tattoos. More tattoos sort of becomes a pain to manage. And we'll give it to him on his front, and maybe, like, on his leg. So let's see what we've got here. Alright. We give him another thief, but I don't think we want to do that. Oh, we can give him the stupid, shitty vampire tattoo. It's like, I got this pentagram on my leg. It's kind of... No, I wouldn't wish a leg pentagram tattoo on anybody. That one does look super sweet, but I think we're going to save it for somebody else. Words of power, what's that? I don't know, but it's not a leg tattoo. Why don't we just filter for legs? Magic leg? He's just got a wizard fucking tattooed on his leg? No. No. Yeah, it's just like legit leg wizards. Okay, somebody's getting double leg wizards. It's not this guy, but somebody is getting double leg wizards. No, this guy's totally got a douchey Celtic tattoo on his leg. 100%. No, we're not putting a like an angel or a lady on our guy's leg. That's awkward and weird. Yeah, no, he's got a douchey Celtic tattoo. Let's check this thing out, see if we like it. So yeah, just, you know, got some knotwork to, like, commemorate my heritage. Sound like I'm from Australia. So, I mean, not, like, British heritage, but, you know. Yeah, look at this guy. I love this man. Love everything about him. Alright, let's make him a little short. I'm like, let's make his head a little too large. No, let's leave his head normal size. Let's give him that kindness. But he does need a name. I'll wait for chat because I wanna name this guy. I don't just want to call him guy who always has a black eye. Yeah, it's great. He's gonna turn out to be great. We'll see how he grows. Maybe he'll start hanging out with cool people. I mean, we could just call him, like, Paul, because really, he reminds me of Paul Bettany, who is an excellent actor, if an occasionally problematic person. Or like, I don't know, something like super English. But not, like, posh English, like working class English. Clive. I'm digging Clive. Yeah. Clive always makes me think of Clive Owen, but he does not look anything like Clive Owen. Yeah, look at him with his thief tattoo and his leg wrap and his weird, like, howling wolf on his arm. This guy... Skyrim smells like bears and sweat, and this guy smells like Axe body spray. Thanks, Feindahl. What's up, buddy? Yeah, I understand. You just turned your back on me. That seems fine. All right, so let's get this guy in a spreadsheet as Clive. And let's get back into our Skyrim game. So there we are. Clive, good to meet you. So we need to save this guy's presets still. I don't want to lose him. We went to all this trouble to make him as douchey as possible. Clive is a Bravo. I have the hiccups. So alright, let's get back into this. Our Dervish, who we decided is going to be visually impaired in some way. Always heads or tails on the twopence. Our Dervish is also a dude. Okay, so we're going to stay with that. We're going to bot the presets to reset who he is. Rotate the camera so we can actually see what we're looking at. What's up, Jason Momoa? How's it going? Just going to turn you that way. Make you maybe look up. Could you just look at the camera, please? Thank you. God. This guy already deeply more uncooperative than the actual Jason Momoa, who is, if my understanding of him is correct, is a super cool person. I think it was Gail Simone told a story on Twitter today about she was, I guess, hanging out with him as part of the Justice League stuff, because she writes him when he's playing Aquaman, and he, like, calls his family every day, and he just super gushes, and is a super nice guy, and, like, deeply loves his family, and, like, is not ashamed to show that, and she's like, it's so cool, he's such a neat dude. But what's our dervish look like? Shifting because my chair is not as comfortable as it could be. Our dervish looks unexpected. We already, Paul Bettany, we had our time with you. We might use your preset again, and we might change you into somebody else, but I think our dervish is also, maybe he's a bigger dude. We'll use this guy as our base again. There we go. We'll give him a sort of weathered complexion. Like, our dervish is maybe a little older. They've been around. I mean, they're going to go and fight vampires, for God's sake. So, maybe they've got a couple of scars. Yeah. So the notion of dervish, I pulled it from, there's a third edition D&D prestige class. There's a dervish. But essentially it's a person who, like, sort of fights with two weapons, wears a lot of light armor, and dances around in fights. As though they are a whirling dervish. But it's sort of my name for any kind of two-weapon fighter. Because it sort of unpacks into a lot of that stuff for me. And we mentioned that they were going to be visually impaired. So let's see if we can... see if we can actually... There we go. Look at that. So maybe they're blind in this eye, and they've got the scar underneath it, too. So something took out this eye and left a mark on that side of their face. Like that. I mean, they're weathered as shit. What's their hair look like? I mean, the real question... The hair is obviously one of the most customizable things in the game, so it becomes that question of, who is this person? How do I understand them? And through them, understand them because of their hairstyle. So let's maybe... Ooh, that's really... No, we already have a blonde guy. Let's make this their hair sort of brownish. Like that. Or maybe like black. Let's not give them like a super intricate hairstyle either, because they don't care. This gives the impression of a person who gives zero fucks. Like they have seen the horrors of war, and they're so done with them that they're going to go and fight immortal night gods instead of fighting in the Civil War or whatever. So maybe something like this. There's like hair everywhere. Zero fucks given. They're not gonna tuck their hair back in a hat. That looks ridiculous. But they're not gonna spend all that time on their hair with like faux hawks and things like that. Because Paul Bettany, eventually Paul Bettany's gonna style his hair. He'll turn up for the stream one day and he'll be like, oh damn, what's up with Paul Bettany's hair? Or Clive. I guess his name is Clive. I'll call him Clive from now on. I think we want to go with that hairstyle that I saw a little ways back. Yeah, this one. I like this. Let's turn it around. Let's just make sure that I can see what the back's like. Because, it's going to have to interact with his armor. Oh, good. So it comes out a ways, which looks awkward now. But once he's wearing clothes and armor, it's actually going to look all right. Yeah, notice that he's leaned way back in typical Hawkeye Initiative pose. But yeah, like, this is a person who has seen some shit. As a result, I think they have a bigger beard, too. Maybe something like that. Like, they're a little older. They've been through the ringer. and maybe that shows on their face. There's that like hint of contempt for people who don't know what's going on. They're going to get along super great with Isran, who's the leader of the Dawn Guard, who's exactly like this. He's like, no one sees the threat that vampires are, and this person's going to be like, yeah. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I like that. I appreciate how dorky this is. All right. So let's give them some war paint. And them too, I think they're gonna have Where was that? I really like the eagle on their forehead. Like just something that's just straight up, you know, here I am, here is my mark. They're a very straightforward person. I mean, I feel like you can't fight with two weapons and not be a straightforward person. So let's give them some tattoos. Let's give them a chest tattoo. Let's not give them a vampire chest tattoo, though. Let's maybe go with like a dragon and sword over their heart. And I need to clear this filter. Maybe also a belly tattoo. So a bunch of like Saints Row style angel tattoos. Celtic knot over the belly button. Very stylish. Ooh, dragonborn tattoo on the treasure trail. A little weird. Flowers, not really his jam. Vampire, no. Vines. Crossed axes on the stomach. What is that? That's the wolf one. Let's rotate that and take a look at it. That looks pretty cool. Sort of right in the loincloth there. And yeah, let's give him a leg tattoo. We're not going full wizard leg. We are definitely going to... Somebody's going full wizard leg. I don't know who, but somebody in that list we made earlier is going full wizard leg. Maybe our like thief or our spellblade or our leader. They're just like two wizard legs. I like that. Because it looks like it trails into it. But the designs are really different too. This is a guy who wears his history on his body. Man, I dig it. I dig it. I'll make him a little bigger than average. Just like that. I'm going to just tune him up a little bit. We maybe tune up his biceps a bit. I've never tried like tuning the biceps to sort of see where that gets you. This makes him like a little bigger. No, that's going to look weird. Because it doesn't scale his body properly. Things that these settings need, a reset to default slider. Well, given that it's a mod, I can't ask for too much. And he's going to need a name. I want to double check something and then I'm going to name him. I just need to quickly Google something that 20-year-old Jim knew that 13 years later, I'm not sure I remember. Yes, okay. Turns out my memory's better than I thought. I want to call him Pawiak. We'll call him Pavel. Pavel Pawiak. Pawiak is a prison in Poland. And this guy strikes me as the kind of guy who would do well in Polish prison. He does not mess around. He's going to hunt vampires for a living. That's going to be a thing once we get there. All right. So we're going to quick enter Pavel into our spreadsheet. Not everybody can have Western names. It's boring and colonial. There we go. Alright, so show race menu once again. So we can save this preset. I love that it's 8:30 and all I'm doing is playing with sliders. But spoilers, that's all we're gonna do tonight. Is play with sliders, probably. We're not actually going to like progress at all in this game. We're just going to play with sliders, and then I'm going to go to bed, and I'm going to go to bed happy, and I'm going to sleep like a baby. So yeah, let's save this preset. And because let's instead of Pavel the Dervish, we'll call him Pavel the Tempest. Which is another two-weapon fighting prestige class from 3rd edition D&D. Because there's a whole bunch of them, you can never have too many of them. Okay, so next up is our Thunder God. And I lost my two-pence piece. I don't remember what I did with it. Did I throw it on the floor? Oh, there it is. It's underneath my phone. So I will super dream about sliders, and they will be happy, happy dreams. Alright. Our Thunder God is a lady. Sweet. This is gonna be rad. I never really got a chance to play my Thunder God. Let's dial back the expression. Oh no, right, because we switched genders. So it's reset. Okay, good. Presets for a Thunder God. Kind of digging that first one. Just sort of that high hair. We're going to bump the weight up a bunch. And maybe bump the skin tone to there. That feels good. Yeah, no, I'm going to do them both sliders, and it's going to be amazing. Thunder God is a little dirty, but has no scars. My understanding of the, like, I want to understand this person as, like, a person who, like, becomes the Thunder, like they're legit an incarnate Thunder God. They're like a Thunder Daedra that inhabits a human form. Fadal's like, what? Listen, buddy, we'll get there. Don't worry. We'll get there. Alright, so eyes. Yeah, let's just make them, like, white. Like, this isn't blindness. This is simply, you know, the results of inhuman majesty. Hair. Do we have white hair as an option? Yeah, we do. Not that I want to go with white hair, but we're also not going with this hairstyle, but maybe sort of like gray? And we're going to need like a cool ass Thunder God haircut. We're not gonna spike it up because again, if Janet catches anybody messing with her hairstyle, she's gonna kill him. Princess Leia? No. I'm digging the short hair, though. I also point out that these haircuts are so high-res that they occasionally cause my very powerful computer to lag. Thunder God just wears her hair up in this, like, super awesome bun. That actually seems kind of cool. Well, that's pretty sweet. I guess the question is, are we a punk Thunder God, or are we a, like, badass Thunder God? I think badass is the answer. What's that? That looks pretty rad. You seriously don't fuck with Janet. If there's one thing we're gonna learn in the next however long I do this stream, it is that Janet will wreck your day. And she will wreck your day for basically no reason at all. Awkward white lady cornrows. That's a thing. No, that's just... Oh, they're like super straight. Let's take a quick look around the back. It's a little too close to her body, so it's going to clip through a bunch of meshes. I swear to God that most of these hairstyles are like only used by people who play basically with the character's shirt off. That's pretty sweet. Oh, there's a braid. That is the title of our next Skyrim stream, by the way, John, is You Don't Fuck With Janet. And we're going to go and kill a dragon. It's going to be... The Thane of... Or the Jarl of Whiterun's going to be like, oh, God, good. I'm glad you came. I understand that you are not the person to be fucked with. I like such a person. Right, hon, we need to find your haircut. I want something like maybe short but pulled back still. Yeah, like some of these, they look so cool. And then you put armor on and it just clips through the front a whole bunch and you're like, oh, this looks so awkward. Even though I barely ever look at this character because I'm basically inhabiting their brain. That's pretty sweet. 280. 280 is a good Thunder God haircut. Let's just keep flipping a little bit. Ideally, I'm not going to go through 100% of these haircuts. Straight up beehive? I guess if you're the Thunder God, it's a lightning rod. Oh, it's a little, like, crown. That's pretty sweet. A Sindel haircut from Mortal Kombat. The world is our hair oyster. Don't eat hair oysters. That's pretty sweet, actually. I think we're gonna go to 280. 187, I don't know. I feel like we maybe want to use it for somebody else who's a little more, like, cash. Yeah. There's a... So here's what we're going to do. We're going to make the Thunder God sort of puzzled by mortality and... No, we're not, because that looks really weird. Let's go with mood puzzled, maybe? No. That's... Sad? God, that looks awkward. Just look right. Oh, God! Ah! Oh, God! Please put your eyes back in your head. Please. I promise I won't. Whatever just happened. Squint. Alright, let's bump the anchor a bit. So it's, yeah, it's a sort of determined anger. We need to dial it back a bit because we're exposing the mesh through the chin. There we go, 35. And let's sort of bump that eyebrow squint. Oh, it's not an eyebrow squint. Let's go with combat anger. No. Oh, there we are. Brow down. Right. Brow down left. There we go. Look at that. And we'll maybe... show some teeth. No, that looks ridiculous. Mouth closed. So here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna take some war paint. We're gonna give her like this completely bomb ass war paint on the right side of her face. That looks pretty sweet. Eye of Ra, not so much there. Yeah, so it's... oh no, there's something under her hair. But most of it is on her neck and on that side of her face. Body paint. I think back tattoos are going to be important. But we're not going to leave her with the sick vampire tattoo. What have we got in the way of dragonborn tattoos? I feel like that'll be a fun one. Oh, right, that's Janet's tattoo. Do we want to give her Janet's tattoo? Kind of. Let's give her the dragonborn leg one. Let's give her a tattoo. Maybe nature tattoos? So, like, vines? The sick magic back tattoo. Or like flowers. That looks cool. I can dig that. So we can give her another flower tattoo. That looks cooler. Okay. So let's rotate back around. We're going to get rid of that back tattoo and we're maybe going to put something on the front. And then we'll swap that dragonborn. There we go. So she's got a bunch of like nature tattoos and flowers and stuff. But definitely the wrathful portion of nature. Body scales, let's make her a little taller, but not as tall as Janet. And she's also going to need a name. Really, I think there's only one name for a thunder god. Regardless of gender, I mean, she's probably essentially non-binary. So they, I guess, is the correct term. Or is a term. I think that's the pronoun that you would most identify with. But their name is... as I mentioned, there's only one name. Ooh, we're in the load screen. Cancel. Save. Is, of course, most famous thunder god of all, Raiden. Thor can suck it. Besides, they did Lady Thor. So we're gonna do Lady Raiden. She's the bomb. Alright, so we're gonna get her entered in the spreadsheet here as Raiden. So we got like 8 more to go. Man, it's going to be bedtime. Ideally, we're not going to continue this next week. Next week, we'll actually, you know, do quests and fight things and progress. People are coming into my stream and they're like, oh my god, fucking dude, stop playing with sliders. Fucking stop it. That's okay. I understand. Next up is our War Archer. Trust me when I tell you that when all this shakes out, it's going to be really cool. But you got to do the preliminary work. So, 2 pence found. War Archer is a dude. Running pretty even on... dudes versus ladies here. Which is good. I'm glad. If we get out of whack, I might actually, I'll sort of artificially reinforce it. I think Jason Momoa's manager, I think this guy's our war archer. He has that look of, like, the sort of underclass, not underclass, but, working class hero of the Empire kind of thing. You know, maybe he's Clive's brother or something. Turns out bopping your skin tone turns all your tattoos clear. That's cool. So yeah, we'll make him a little more like sun-kissed. It's like, I like how it goes from like clear down to like tan down to like Italian through to like North Africa if you're being very charitable. This guy's been a... If this guy is related to Clive, he's definitely Clive's older brother. Actually, instead of giving him scars, maybe we'll mess with his complexion a bit. So yeah, he's just sort of older. Some dirt. Alright. Eyes. Oh, Clive's got those super blue eyes, doesn't he? So we'll give him blue eyes too. Yeah. I'm gonna use Clive's brother. So, he doesn't have a 5 o'clock shadow. He's got, like, something sort of reasonable. Clive's blonde, right? So, we'll make him... Not dark-haired, but yeah. Oh, we should make him ginger. Yeah, you're a ginger. If this isn't red hair, please somebody in the chat correct me. Because I am, as I've mentioned before, super colorblind. But if it is red hair, also please let me know because it will restore my confidence. But don't lie to me because I need this. You're not that old, buddy. Oh my god, that looks brilliant. And this is like blonde. I can see now. This I think is sort of more ginger. Just give him the faux hawk. No. I feel like growing up with Clive means you're a little more of a grown-up and you don't have a faux hawk. Let's start from the other end. Oh god. What happened to your hair, son? Let's try and find you something that doesn't make you look like Fabio's second cousin. This is also blonde, isn't it? I have no idea. So you're a war archer. With highlights, maybe? No, that's Pavel's haircut. Yeah, maybe you're Clive's older brother and he wants to, like, grow up and be you, but he hasn't figured out who you are yet. Like, for real? So maybe you do have great hair. Maybe you just got highlights and you're just, like, a boss archer. No, let's... So let's go back and with that sort of knowledge, let's make you a bit younger, maybe? And maybe tweak your hair color a touch. Just make it a bit darker. Oh god. This is, if you want to make a character who is Rhett from Rhett and Link, you can use this haircut. There we go. That's a little more like military cut. Let's give him a different beard. Something like that, maybe, with the sideburns. The more I do this, the more he starts to look like skinny Chris Hemsworth. If Chris Hemsworth had a really narrow face. So I guess not at all like skinny Chris Hemsworth. I'm gonna maybe bump his weight up a bit. Just to sort of fill him out. Yeah, so you can see the muscle structure change with the weight, too. Like, they go from being gaunt to sort of filling out their shoulders, and then just start becoming gigantic He-Men. To the point where it changes the shading on their crotch. So I want to get, I think, to that point just... There we are. There, now he looks a little less lanky. You look like bomb-ass Cary Elwes. Like, you do... He does, though. He looks like the person that Clive wants to grow up and be. And while Clive is, like, screwing around with the Thieves Guild and, like, shooting people with crossbows and fighting with a rapier, like, this guy is... He's got a war axe and a longbow, and he's fighting in a real war. All right. Now, his expression, I think, will also make him happy. But we will make him happier than Clive. So Clive has that, like, slight smile. But his is sort of more genuine. He's like, no, this is a thing that I'm doing. And we'll, yeah. No, we don't want to surprise him too much. He's going to look like he's about to cry. But yeah, he looks sort of open. Like, this is a person who's really in touch with their feelings and understands what they want out of life. And it's... This is a person who, I think, can't imagine not having a war to fight, but at the same time deeply hopes that they don't have a war to fight. So let's go with the war paint. And Clive had... What did Clive had? Clive had the like... Ankh tattoo or whatever. Maybe this guy gets the spiral. That one actually looks pretty nice. It's sort of understated. This guy also clearly has a British accent. Maybe his tattoo matches his brother's. Yeah. Like, maybe they just both have the same tattoo. Body paint. Let's take a look here. What was that? He's got a sword down the side of his arm. I feel like he's got small tattoos. Like, not... Because Clive had, like, the douchey wolf arm, and he does not have wizard legs. We're not there yet. There's not... Nobody here is the wizard-like chosen one. If you leave the stream... You're never going to find out who the wizard leg chosen one is. She's got a full body dragon tattoo. That actually seems pretty awesome. And... So let's take a look at what that looks like. So he's got the knotwork on his arms, again, to sort of capture that heritage. He's got a dragon that actually runs like the length of his left side, and then the crossed axes. I think we're going to replace the crossed axes with something. We can get something in his lower back, maybe. A pair of crossed swords on his back. This is his bad mistake tattoo. That, like, he got a tattoo because it was cool, like, because his army unit all got it, and his little brother's like, oh my god, I need to get tattoos. And that's how this whole thing started. This is maybe a little cooler. But he's just like, what's your tattoo, man? Oh, I got my whole back done. I've got these crossed, like, dragon swords on my back. You know, so I'm never unarmed. And his brother's like, oh my god, that's so awesome. And he's just like, he's completely embarrassed of it now. Yeah, we have to go with the crossed backswords. The backstory's too good. And so he's got these other tattoos that, like, mean things to him. You know, the dragon to represent Skyrim and his time there. The knotwork to represent, like, his homeland. And then these fucking... cross swords where they're like, what does that represent? He's like, a mistake. Life was unfortunate. Alright, sometimes when you're very drunk, you make bad decisions. Alright. Spin this guy back around. He's just like, listen, this guy's super responsible. Like, this is a guy who clearly pays his taxes to the Lord on time while he is, you know, waging a rebellion. He is our Robin Hood figure, our sensible adult in a group, like, to the point where he might be Janet's love interest. We'll see. Alright, I like this guy. And we are going to name him... Henry. Henry, I think, is a good name for Clive's older brother. Henry the War Archer. Because that is what he does. He's not a hunter. He doesn't, like, make a camp and shoot food. I mean, he probably does that too, but, like, chiefly, he's a soldier. So here we are, Henry. Look at this guy in the spreadsheet. Actually, we don't really need to worry about getting him in the spreadsheet because I forgot that I have all these saved. I'm super good at this. I've never actually done this part publicly. This is the part of Skyrim that was like really sort of private for me and kind of my own. So it's really neat to be able to do that. What we are going to do is name him just so we can restart the character creation process. All right. So next up is our thief. Get our tuppence out. Or our, no, this isn't a 2 pence. This is a 2 pound. A tuppen? I don't know. You tell me. All right, here we are. That didn't really spin. That just sort of wobbled in midair. There we go. Tails again. Kind of long on dudes now. Executive decision, our thief and our bravo are not both dudes. Archetypes are too similar. Look at that. Half of flipping coins is understanding the decision you wish you'd made. So, our thief. Now, our thief is going to get mixed up in the Dark Brotherhood. Feel like I really like her eyeshadow. All right, you're a thief. Oh my god, your tattoos just turned white. That actually looks super cool. Now we're gonna give you white tattoos. We're gonna try anyway. No, you're pretty fair. We might want to like drop your body weight a bit. You know, maybe make her sort of gaunt. Here. Because, yeah, otherwise she'll wind up the same size as Janet, and nobody's the same size as Janet because you don't fuck with Janet. It's never going to get old, by the way. Like, I'll be streaming this 2 years from now, and I'll be like, you don't fuck with Janet. Okay, we have a whole bunch of people with blue eyes. I don't understand what human mystery eyes look like. Like, what? I don't know. I barely know what color my own eyes are. Nebula, that seems cool. It looks cool. It contrasts well with her face. Says the colorblind guy. Alright. So dark hair is also cool, but let's give you a better haircut. Let's give you... You're a thief, right? So you're like all about short functional haircuts anyway. I feel like... We want to give you... One of those haircuts. Something like this, maybe? Something a little less faux... Tribal, though. Oh, I understand what happened there. My desktop is messing around with me. It doesn't like what I'm doing in this mouse-ridden environment. I'm gonna have to mess around with that in between streams. It'd be super fun for Bedtime Jim, who's gonna be just jazzed to stay up late. Not really. Oh, what's up, Rich? How's it going? Yeah. Making Skyrim characters. Time. Oh, we could give her the hipster hat. I'm really not feeling that, but... We could. It's a little too on the nose, I think. There's some punk haircuts in here somewhere, though. Do I know where they are? No. There's 400 haircuts in this list, and we're just going to flip through them until I find the one that I'm looking for like a monster. Listen, we're going to have to live with her forever, and yeah, sure, I could change her hair later, but I'd rather get it right now. Oh, there we go, there we go. Yeah. Look at that. Assassin is shit. Expressions. No, we're gonna make her mad. Not that mad. Oh, you're playing D&D tonight, Rich? What are you playing? God, her eyebrows are so high. But it gives her this cool, like, that cool eyeshadow. Yeah, so she's, like, narrow-eyed. She's sort of not so much angry as, like, mistrusting. Like, this is a person who's been wronged by the world. We're gonna need a... She's gonna need a name, by the way. I don't have a good one in mind. So... Yeah, she's gonna need a name. I forgot I had water. Deep Gnome Wizard. Sweet. Is that 5th edition? Or, Yeah, you'd mentioned that it was 5th. Okay, so now we're gonna go into the Warpaint. I actually think we want to go the other way with the war paint. Right? Tempted to just leave this, but we already have somebody with this war paint. I feel like if you're a thief and you have a big face tattoo, it's really not super... You break out into hives doing thinking about doing 3.5 again. I don't blame you. Yeah, like rather than a face tattoo, maybe like a neck tattoo like this. This is a little more subtle. You can cover it with armor. I mean, she's going to be assassinating people, but her concept is a thief. So let's zoom out. And yeah, let's again, rather than Maybe tune that down like a little bit. Like it's a little too white. It looks like paint. Eh, we'll deal. Let's figure out what tattoos we're gonna put on. Wow, that's... Yeah, no, that's... That's a little too much. Alright. So she's gonna need a thief tattoo. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna... There we are. Now we can... is this a vanilla body and skin? Yes. I don't have any body mods. I do have my graphics turned up, but... I don't like using body mods because I use a lot of armor mods. And if I have to pick between having, like, slightly better looking character bodies and a bazillion different kinds of cool-ass armor, I will take armor every day. Alright, so let's get her a thief tattoo first. Let's put hers on her arm. So got one on the back there. Back of the leg, maybe, too. That's kind of cool. I think we want... Yeah, let's go back of the leg, actually. I like that. You know, it's a thief mark. It's like a brand or something. That you get when you steal things. And then what's the... there was one that was like... My things or something? Taking business. I want to see what that is. We're going to spin her back around. I don't think she's going to get one of those sick full body back tattoos. Oh, the keys on the front. Yeah. Alright. So, taking business. So, we're going to give her a different thief tattoo. just because I want that taking business keys thing. That one looks real cool. Literally all the other ones are like on her back or on her arms. Oh, or it just takes them a little bit to load. What's Thief 9? Let's take a look. Oh, on the back of her forearm. That's pretty sweet. And so we can get her stand facing down a bit so we don't destroy her back. And let's see if we can get something for like the upper body. I don't know about belly, although the floral belly is pretty good. Flower on the hip is not really visible. Hail Sithis, not exactly. We're not going full wizard legs. We will, though. Trust me. Somebody is getting wizard legs, and it's going to be amazing. I just don't know who that is yet. Fines. We're not going to give her the sword that runs down her arm, especially because she's already got a tattoo on that arm. Axes around the... what is with friends? Oh, that's weird. It's like a bunch of skulls at the base of your back. That's not really what I'm looking for in a tattoo. Straight up big giant dragon on the whole front of her body. We're not doing that for her, but somebody's getting that. You better fucking believe it. Maybe that. That looks pretty nice. Like, it's tucked underneath, so it's not entirely visible. And it sort of runs up into the keys. I like that. Okay. So we've got expression. We're going to need body scale. Let's get her down. Make her really short. Make her like 0.94, 0.95. And she is going to need a name. What is her name? Happy to take suggestions from the chat. So this is she's a thief. She's probably from Riften. She lives there maybe, we don't know yet. And we are going to, you know, she's gonna wind up getting mixed up in the Dark Brotherhood and things like that. So, what's her name? Rich, you are banned from naming things. That's true. Let us call her Leona. Leona the Thief. I don't do surnames for Skyrim characters, mostly because there's no real spot for it. Okay. Next character is our leader, who's going to do the Bard College quests. Coin flip. Our leader's a dude. That seems fine. Alright. Welcome, dudesman. Change our presets a little bit. So you're a leader, you're gonna be the Bard's College. You look like somebody who's in charge of people. You look like somebody's manager. Yeah, we're gonna go with that guy. The one who looks like somebody's dad. Oh, Rich mixed the original screen stream where I talked about the multiplicity and how we're doing this. So we're going to play all these characters all at once in a long-term Skyrim stream. It's going to be really fun. Trust me. Trust me. We're going to make you... No, we're not going to make you necessarily whiter. We're going to sort of bop you down a little bit. Ooh, oh, canceled. There we are. Or you're keeping that mustache too, buddy. But we're going to give you some new eyes. That's your eye shape. Your eye color. So many, like, different kinds of leather? Oh, they're brown. Of course, they're brown. They're brown like leather. Leather is brown. I understand colors. Probably. Maybe. Alright, hair. Son, get a haircut. Maybe we give you, like a buzz cut? Looks not bad. Like, you, it makes him look much more severe, but not like the perfect haired dudes. Yeah, I think I'm digging the shaved head. No, you said you're keeping the mustache, so you're keeping the mustache. But if we can find you, like, a better mustache? No. Handlebar mustache for life, at least until maybe you get married and they make you shave it off. Hair color is fine. Expressions. So right now you don't have one. That's okay. Make you go, Oh God. Big awe. Oh, the Soul Reaver. No, I think you're pretty happy. I think you're kind of a douchebag. I think you're one of those, like, you're sort of a bad manager, but you're, like, really, really happy. Trying to figure out why the mesh is cracking underneath his eyes. Happiness isn't... The smile doesn't really show under the... puzzled? Oh my God, that looks brilliant. He's just like, what? What? Yeah. Dial it back just a little bit. Look at that man. Look at his confusion. Look at his mustache. Oh, sir. Sir, I think we got there. I think it's time to go full wizard leg. First, we need to give him some face paint. I think he is a full face paint kind of guy. This guy has, like, an officious posh name. Like, he's the posh guy. Who, like, doubles down on everything. Never admits that he's wrong. And is in charge of a bunch of people. Like, basically, he's some kind of terrible garbage human who somehow manages to survive because he's very good at what he does. Oh, we could have given... No, we can give somebody... please make a note that we can give somebody a scorpion on their face. No, I think that's his thing. So he's like, not only is he arching his eyebrow, but his tattoo runs over his arched eyebrow. All right. So... save color. We're doing it. We're going full wizard leg. Magic leg one. Magic leg two. Because he's going to be... He's our big magician. Like, he's summons creatures and conjures things. And I think we're just going to go full magic tattoos. Gonna look ridiculous. I'm really looking forward to it. Like, and he's just in the back tattoo. I don't know what the back tattoo is. So let's zoom out and take a look. So for one thing, let's turn him around. What's our back tattoo? It's a giant ass dragon around a sword. Perfect. Perfect. The only way I could ask for something any better is if there's a, like a chest tattoo. Which there is not. There's a shoulder one. Let's take a look at those. Let's turn them back around. Alright. So. Shoulder. We've got like some kind of fireball-y thing. Oh, wizard shoulder. 100%. 100% mono wizard shoulder. So now, let's zoom out a bit. We've got wizard shoulder. Spin him back around. Too far. We've gone too far. I'm gonna go down. Wizard on the left, wizard on the right. Oh yeah. This guy covered in, like, he's like a secret wizard fanboy. Like, he just tattoos. He gets tattoos of all of his favorite wizards. And he's like, here's my Archmage Savos tattoo on my whole left leg. And it's great, but he doesn't talk about it ever because it's a secret shame. Oh, I love it. I love it! Let's make him regular size. And this guy's name... It's gonna have a posh name, but I don't want it to be so long that you have to constantly, like, shorten it. So I want it to be, like, Reginald or something like that. That's too much. But I do want it to have two syllables, so it's probably not gonna be, like, Charles. We already have a Henry. It's also a little... We're skewing a little British right now, so... Philip, digging it. I think we're skewing a little sort of British. I'm thinking Nicholas. But I guess it shortens to Nick. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna save this preset. And we will call him Nikolai. No, that's too much GTA 4 stuff. Nicholas the Leader. Nicholas is kind of a jackass. And, No, we just lost Pavel. Oh no, I'll go back and get him. I'll review the stream and we'll just fix him up. Dear mod, I need you to be a little more consistent than you are. There we are. Okay, so he's at least saved. I'll go back afterward and sort of reassemble Pavel into a person. Sad face about losing Pavel. Pavel's our vampire hunter. He's going to be so cool. Alright. Next up we have our fortress. No, Pavel... Don't talk down about Pavel. Pavel's awesome. I'm going to go back through the video and, like, reconstruct it. It'll be super straightforward. Because I pretty much know... I'll do it afterward. Always forward, ever forward. God, this guy looks so... He doesn't look like a douchebag either. Like, he just looks like a jerk. Our fortress. Get our coin out. Our fortress is a lady. Neat. That actually might complicate our lives slightly. Okay with that. So she's a lady. Please change the preset. I think that is the preset I want to go with, though. We're going to bump the weight. Bump the skin tone a bit. Change it to that. We're a little darker complexion. She's got dirt. She's got scars. So we got war paint. We're gonna pull the war paint off because we're gonna put our own on. Eyes. I want them to, I want them to be like gray. My impression of this person is that, like, so this is the person who's gonna do all of our Thane quests. They're gonna have a huge two-handed weapon. They're gonna fight with fire spells. Oh, so maybe we want to give them like. Do we have red eyes? Is that a thing? Please, could you boil? What? What does that mean? What does any of this mean? Outsider, passion, purple death, human reptile. There we are. So she's got rust eyes, so red eyes. I'm just looking to see if there's something that's. A little more in tune with that. I think rust is good. I was looking for something that says red. There's dragon eyes? I don't know what that means in context. Those are pretty cool. I could just see sort of striking eyes. Hair. It's a fortress, but maybe. Oh, I like that. Yeah, like it's short, but it's kept. Oh, it's not a hairband either. Those are bangs. I think we maybe. It's too clean for the rest of her. That looks pretty boss. Like, she's just a dirty face, but immaculate hair. She's a woman of, like, deep precision. Maybe tweak the color a bit. Sort of playing with the sliders now. So playing with sliders is one of the best parts of this game. Maybe we're gonna take that dirt off. No, we're gonna leave some of it on. And we're gonna change that hair. It's a little too posh. Alright, there's a ponytail attached to that. I think the war paint is really gonna pull her together. Like as a character, I think. Where she exists is that. Oh my god, that's so rad. No, we want to make her hair a little darker. Yeah, so, yeah, they already, like, some of the stuff just clips through. Give her a giant beehive. Nobody's improving the look of my Skyrim. It looks wonderful. I enjoy it. It also lets me stream without dropping frames, which is nice. So, I think she's a little sort of narrow-eyed. Right here. Sort of, like, soft-hearted. Does that look? Let's maybe make her smile a little bit. No. No. Severe. Responsible. Like, this is a person who is going to kill people in order to become Thane. Because it is what needs to be done. Gonna zoom in and pick a texture. But I think her war paint is unsubtle. I don't know that it's skull on face or spiral on face unsubtle, but I don't think it's one of these, like, tiny, half-assed side of your face war paints. I think she's got, like, a full... Yeah, something like that. Might take a look at the Nord war paint as well. She doesn't look like Darth Maul. That's pretty cool. So let's scroll up a bunch. So we've also got the option of all of the... Yeah, I like that. It's just divided by a single stripe. Okay. But other reasons I haven't improved the look of my Skyrim more than I already have. I need it to not crash every 20 minutes. Spin her around. It's not really what I was looking for in a back tattoo, I gotta admit. I think we're also gonna give her the full body dragon. I think that is a thing that she would rock. What is that vampire arm? That looks awful. Like, this is a person who is serious. This is a person who is professional. Like, this is a person who carries a giant sword, axe, or hammer and puts them through your body until you yield to the Lord of the Region. This is not a person who screws around. Oh no, the weapon's back was the giant cross sword thing. That's right, I forgot. Wolf Prince we did. Let's go a little further up here. Let's straight up get a tattoo of a fairy. Not so much there. Matching dragon on the other side. That's some pretty Skyrim shit right there. What is the crow? It's literally just a crow that is tattooed across your back. Tattooed the symbols of Skyrim, crows and dragons and something else. Where's the giant full? We're just gonna go like full dragon. So we've got the dragon around the neck, the dragon around the back, or on the side, and the dragon on the leg. Sounds good. I like it. Dig it. Sliders. Let's make her a little bigger. She's got a giant sword. Presets. Who is this? She is a fortress. She's going to become Thane. She is... I don't want to use Elena. Yeah, Elena? Elena. She's gonna wear some boss-ass heavy armor. Alright. So, she got saved. Right? Yes, good. Next up, our Death Knight. Our Death Knight is also a lady. So we're gonna set this preset just to reset it. Please look at me. Move our camera up a little bit. There we go. Oh, oh, oh. I like her for a Death Knight. I'm gonna make her pale and gaunt. Gaunt but tall, I think. Complexion is a bit weathered. She has a couple of scars. Eyes. We're just gonna straight give her the we're gonna find some all white eyes. There we are. Pale. Like she's literally dead. Raised from the dead to stalk the earth and serve the Daedra. Yeah. I like the idea that our Death Knight is Dark Janet. What happens if you fuck with Janet? She'll kill you. Oh, Rick. You're so funny. We're not going to make her hair a bright yellow to make her a Super Saiyan. Because that's Janet. She's the Dragonborn. She's a Super Saiyan Dragonborn. You were not here for last stream. It was a good time. Alright. So let's give her some serious war paint. The other thing about the modded war paint is it's a little higher resolution. I like that. I like that especially because it showcases her eyes. But there was one that I saw that I think would work pretty well. Not the dragon stuff, not the treble clef. Oh god, that looks amazing. We're gonna remember number 50 because I think I wanna see what this one looks like, but I think number 50 is the real war paint. You know, you don't look like Darth Maul. You don't have a butterfly in the middle of your noggin. You'd have a kitty on your cheek. That one also looks pretty cool, but again, that's sort of Darth Maul-ish. So that was the one I was thinking about, but no, 50s are a clear winner. 50s are, I just fucked somebody up something bad. Here's my, like, terrifying eldritch maw. Tattoo-wise, we're gonna give her the, the vampire back tattoo. And the chest. And the belly. So we've got sort of vampire-y type things here. And then this giant, like, sick-ass winged cross thing. These are, like, ritual markings. You know, this is what you need to have to, like, make to revive someone from the dead. I mean, obviously you don't need that because you can do it however you want. But we'll make her a little taller. Actually, I do want to scale up her weight. So maybe we'll make her, like, physically large. Like, so she'll be imposing. Alright. She also needs a name. God, that looks freaky as hell. Her name is what? What do you think? Given life. Awesome. That looks friggin' sweet. I don't care who you are. Her name is not Candy. I don't think she'd like that name very much. Like, this is like someone who, like, came back from the dead and someone asked her what her name was, and she was like, I don't remember anything, and just made one up. We might change it later. We'll see. I'm gonna do some, like, fine-tuning. Alright, so next up is our Spellblade, who's gonna do the Helgen Reborn quest and rebuild the village of Helgen. Dude! Alright. So, not you. We've got a plan for that preset. She could be a badass named Candy, but I don't know. It doesn't sit right with me. Like, that is not a name that when I look at her, I do not go, this is a person who would identify as Candy. Like, this might be a person who, like, would take the name Candy as sort of like an offhand thing, and then people would make fun of her for it, and she would change it. I think she's sort of slightly self-conscious about her lack of humanity, but at the same time, a merciless Daedra-fueled killing machine. And trying to reconcile those two things. I like this preset for our Spellblade. This guy's going to fight with Sword and Ward. So maybe Conjure Blades, maybe Physical Ones. He's an eye color. All but the pale eye colors today. Give him some hair. Candy the Butcher of Skyrim? It's possible. We'll see. She might become Candy yet. We'll give him, like, the full, like, Rhett hair. And the full, like, Rhett beard. Like, just the full Riker. Now let's bop that hair down a little bit. Nah, actually, I'm digging it. It's my hair. It's what my hair is doing right now. All right. So this guy's a Spellblade. I guess the question is, how serious is he? He's surprised because he's seen some shit at Helgen. Oh, not that surprised. Maybe not dialogue surprise. Is there a mood surprise? Yes, good. So yeah, like, he's open. And let's see if we can make him happy a little bit. So this is a guy who, like, quit the college at Winterhold and wound up mixed up in with a bunch of ex-legionnaires outside of Helgen. Really not digging that hair. We need to change it. It's too high. We can give him the British fringe. What's this? Just sort of, like, pulled back. We already made our dude with douchey haircut. Maybe he's our, like, regular Skyrim haircut guy. No, these haircuts are awful. I wouldn't wish that on him. Maybe he's the Fauxhawk guy. No, I wouldn't wish that on him either. Roland? I'm digging that. I'm digging Roland. Yeah, we could do that. Oh, wait. What's this? Maybe play with his hair color a bit. We're not giving you one, two dreads, man. I like you and everything, but that's why. It's just too perfect. No, I think this is the one he gets. I think he gets the rat. Maybe darken his hair a bit. Yeah. All right. So let's give him some more paint. So right now he's got the sidebar. I think. Do we want to give this guy a scorpion on his face? I want to give him something up high so it doesn't interfere with his beard. Oh, or something down low. Is it on both sides? I was kind of hoping it wouldn't be. Digging Roland as a name. Like, the more I think... Oh, there we go. It's just over his beard. It's sort of like descending eagle. I dig it. Alright. Body paint. Right now he's full on wizards. We need to change that. This man... I think we're going to give him the keys, like the thief. I think we're gonna give him. Because I think maybe he used to be a thief. I think we might give him weapon arms. They're just weapons on both arms. The idea being that he keeps his armaments, like, inside himself. And that's sort of embodied in his tattoos. Body scale, let's make him a little tall. We'll save this preset as Roland Spellblade. Okay. Last one. Which is good because it's almost bedtime. At least for me. I get up at 5. So, and I go and work out. You can see my workout videos on ArtPress. Which I don't think is youtube.com/ArtPress because of reasons. The very last one is our knight. And our knight is also a dude. So we're going to use a different preset. I'm going to use this guy. And I like the idea of this knight being older. Being sort of weathered. And being like an old blade. I mean, what knights do, he's going to do Worm's Tooth. And he is going to kill dragons. That is his thing. Knights kill dragons. So let's give him some dark brown eyes. This might be a little too reflective. Well, I can give him dragon eyes. Sure, sounds great. Sort of peering out of his face. I like his hair, actually. I think we want to leave him balding. Knights are not racist against dragons. Dragons despoil the countryside and burn people to death, and one of them is even living in heaven and consuming the souls of heroes. He's not surprised. He's not happy. He's just sort of determined. Yeah. There we go. He's your disapproving grandpa. Now, let's give him some war paint. He's obviously got some kind of, like, dragony thing. Again, we're not giving him the Darth Maul war paint. Is that a dragon or a seahorse? I can't tell. Just give him the barbed wire necklace. That looks awful. Maybe even, let's go up to like Nord. Maybe pass him one of these. I like the idea of, yeah, the dark eyes, maybe? Or the hand. And then for body paint, I'll tell you what we're gonna do. We're just gonna go, like, mono scales. We're actually gonna bop in three more tattoos. So I can't actually get all the scales tattoos. But I can get these ones. So what he winds up looking like is a person who is like carefully tattooed scales on themselves. We might strip the belly and the leg scales and go with something else. Why does it say you're a sub to me? Probably because I'm a top. No, I have no idea. Especially since I don't think I have subscribers enabled. But thanks for stopping by. We are making Skyrim characters. Like a monster. And then this last one here. There we go. Look at that. This is a man who does not get tired of killing dragons ever in his life. He has scales tattooed on his butt. There's a story behind this hand, and I don't know what it is yet. He has killed dragons for a long time. His name is Siegfried. That is, at least for now, the last of our characters. So, next week, I'm going to... Here, let me... I'm going to attempt to understand my streaming setup. Oh, there we are. Yes, so next week I'm going to actually do things with these characters and stream with them. And we're going to progress and actually go through some quests. And it's going to be a pretty good time. So until then, you can find me at the stuff below. Let me shuffle into my actual camera angle here. So at Jay Tigwell on YouTube, my camera is reversed. There we are. On Wootsuit Riot, making Minecraft videos and things like that. Follow me on Twitter, etc., etc. And I'm going to be at Maker Expo in September, on September 10th. It's going to be a good time. We're going to do it live at an 8-hour podcast where we might talk about Skyrim, but we're probably just going to talk about robots because there's going to be a bunch of people there who build robots. That's going to be rad. But in the meantime, I am going to go to bed because I am sleepy and because I have to get up at 5 and exercise like a chump. So I will see you all later. Have a good night.